Hello, in this lecture we will study about the resonance in LCR series circuit, that is series resonant circuit. A series resonant circuit is the circuit in which inductor L, capacitance C and resistance R are connected in series. The impedance of this circuit has a minimum value and the current through the circuit is maximum. An interesting characteristic of the series LCR circuit is the phenomena of resonance. The phenomena of resonance is common among the systems that have a tendency to oscillate at a particular frequency. This frequency is called the system's natural frequency. If such a system is driven by an energy source at a frequency that is equal to the natural frequency, then the amplitude of oscillation is found to be large and it is called resonance. As you know, the impedance of the circuit is of an LCR circuit is equal to under root of R square plus XL minus XC whole square. As you know, XL is equal to omega L and XC is equal to 1 upon omega C. So the impedance can be written in this way. And that you know very well that the current is equal to the V upon resistance. So here we put the value of the impedance and it is the current through the series LCR circuit. And it is a phase angle between the current and the voltage, which is given in this way. Just in place of XL, we put omega L. In place of XC, we put 1 upon C omega. Now, at low frequency, inductive reactance is small, but the capacitive reactance is high. And at high frequency, inductive reactance is large, but the capacitive reactance is small. So at resonance, the inductive reactance is equal to the capacitive reactance, and we can say that the omega L is equal to 1 upon C omega. So when we put omega L equals to omega C or XL equals to XC, we see that the impedance is equal to the resonance. So, at resonance, impedance is equal to the resistance. Similarly, the phase angle between the current and the voltage, as XL equals to XC, so this factor is equal to 0, or we can say that the tan phi is 0, or phi is equal to 0 degree. It means the current and the voltage at resonance is in phase. So, impedance is equal to R and the current is maximum, or circuit is behave as a purely resistive circuit, that is the current and the voltage are in the same phase. This condition is called resonant condition of the circuit and the frequency is called resonant frequency. Now, how to find out the resonant frequency? As at resonance, XL equals to XC and XL equals to omega L and XC is equal to 1 upon C omega. Omega R represents the resonant frequency. So, just rearrange it. Omega R square is equal to 1 upon LC. So, omega R equals to 1 upon root LC. Omega can be replaced by 2 pi n. And so the frequency is 1 upon 2 pi under root LC. It is a resonant frequency. It is a resonant angular frequency. Now, it is a graph between the resonant frequency, between the angular frequency and the current. Now, the current is maximum for the angular frequency. Now it is the R1, R2, R3. The current amplitude decreases with the increase in the value of resistance. So, I think it is clear to all of you the effect of the resistance on the maximum value of the current. This series LCR circuit is also called acceptor circuit. It allows the maximum current through it. This acceptor circuit has a practical applications in many variety of devices. It is used for tuning the mechanism of the radio or the TV set. The antenna of a radio accepts signals from many broadcasting stations. The signal picks up in the antenna act as a source in the tuning circuit of the radio. So as the circuit can be driven at many frequencies, but for one frequency, we tune the radio, and at that time, the capacitance of the capacitor in the tuning circuit is such that the resonant frequency of the circuit is equal to the frequency of the radio signal received. When this happens, the amplitude of the current with the frequency of the signal of the particular radio station in the circuit is maximum. Now let us discuss the resonant curve and the Q factor. Now it is clear up to here. Now we choose the value of omega. Now see, the current is maximum for this resonant frequency. If we choose the value slightly towards the left of the resonant frequency or to the right of the resonant frequency, the value of the current decreases. Suppose we choose a value of omega for which the current amplitude is 1 by root 2 times its maximum value. At this value, the power dissipated by the circuit becomes half, as power is equal to I square into R. If the value of the current is I naught by root 2, then the power becomes half. So the power becomes half at this value. Let this values at which the power becomes half is denoted by omega 1 and omega 2. So omega 1 equals to omega r minus w and omega 2 is equal to omega r plus delta w. So omega 2 minus omega 1 is equal to 2 delta omega, and this 2 delta omega is called the bandwidth of the circuit. The quality factor is defined as the ratio of the resonant frequency to the bandwidth. Here the resonant frequency is omega r and bandwidth is 2 delta omega. So it is a condition of the resonance. From here we can say that the 2 delta omega equals to omega naught upon Q. So larger the value of Q, smaller is the value of 2 delta omega. That is the bandwidth, and sharper is the resonance. If the resonance is less sharp, not only is the maximum current less, the circuit is close to the resonance for the larger range of delta omega frequencies, and the tuning of the circuit will not be good. So less sharp the resonance, or better is the circuit. Thank you and have a nice day.